Change. What does it mean to evolve, to develop, to become? What has changed since the sport of wrestling began? The sport is as old as man. The goal is the same, the strategy is the same, but nonetheless, there has been change. The wrestling surface has changed, the uniforms have changed, the shoes, headgear, training and philosophy have changed. The match format has changed. The length of the season, the design of competition. Each competitor is more athletic, more knowledgeable. So as you, one of the final wrestlers to enter the last match of the 2015-2016 season, how have you changed? To each young man in the bullpen tunnel, you are a finalist in an individual championship match. How have you evolved or developed? What have you become? Ask yourself any of those questions. The answer is obvious to everyone around you, your coaches, your teammates, your family. If you could take a small step backward to see yourself, you too would know that you have become one of the two best wrestlers at your weight in the state of Ohio. You have grown with your sport. You have made the necessary adaptations in order to reach this moment in your evolution. You stand on the brink of the next stage of what you are destined to be. Will you complete the transformation? Will you become the champion? Tonight, this is the wrestling equivalent of natural selection. The strongest will survive. Are you ready to change, to evolve yet again? We will be watching, cheering, and celebrating. Let it begin. Let a champion be chosen. Ladies and gentlemen, your attention is directed to the arena floor and the area in front of the head table. Please congratulate for the year 2016 the Ohio High School Athletic Association State Wrestling Champions. Ladies and gentlemen, in order to honor America, and in respect for all who have served and are presently serving our country in the armed forces throughout the world to defend justice and freedom, you are invited to stand and remove your hats for the presentation of the colors and our national anthem. The colors are presented today by the 2nd of the 107th Cavalry Squadron under the direction of Sergeant First Class Sampson. Making her 24th appearance at the state wrestling finals, Diane Stapleton Robinson retired after teaching English for 35 years at Fairfield High School in Fairfield, Ohio. She is currently active in regional theater in the Fairfield Athletic Hall of Fame Committee. She has been singing at Fairfield High School wrestling events for almost 30 years, but the state wrestling tournament is one of her favorites, singing with 16,000 members of the Ohio High School wrestling family.
Join me. Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars
High School Championship Wrestling, and we've got the 5th and 6th place matches for each weight class today. Ryan, my son, DeSabato, and Phil DeSabato will be leading you on these matches today for 5th and 6th.
All right, here we go, folks. Welcome back to Matt's Side. We've got Shep from Fairfield, Canetano from Solon. 5th place action.
And we're ready to go. The referees are out. We got the match about ready to start. We got Solon's going to be in the green marker and Fairfield in the red marker. Solon shoots in.
Guys, split the middle the there.
Get your foot over his ankle. Keep going.
No takedown yet. They're both wrestling around trying to scramble.
Cantano, he's got a body lock there, but Shup's doing a good job to keep his hips back. Looks like an inside trip.
Take the rush.
Well, and we're back to neutral here. No score yet. Remember, a minute to start the first period here in the consolation round. 1-2-2. Cantona is looking for a 2-on-1.
He's got it. Oh, he throws it by. He's going to try to get that Merkel in.
His weight on the hands, so they give it to. There's a Merkel.
but he loses it.
And there's one escape for Shup. And it's the end of the period. So we got 2-1 to Canetano here to start the second.
Canetano defers. Start the second period. We take Zook. Zook takes down.
Forward. Drive it. Drive, drive.
Canetano looks to throw a leg in there, but Shup does a good job of stand up. Well,
now
he's got to break him down here. Did a good job with that leg there to keep it elevated with his left leg, Canetano.
Tano's doing a good job just basing him out and trying to keep those legs in. He's going to work his upper body a little bit. Puts the claw in. He's trying to go up and turn him. Oh, looks like Shup's trying to get out.
Shup gets up to his feet here. Let's see if he can get out. Canetano reaches in for a single leg there. He's just holding on,
though.
Shup's doing a good job. He's got his hips back here. Canetano's going to be paying for here not to get hit with stalling. And there's a stalemate. Red's still down. 55 seconds left in the second.
Score is still 2-1. And here we go. Back to action. Oh!
Well, there's a reversal. Shup, two. He's got that butcher almost.
He's got to come out front to run that if he wants to get back points. Something blood, it looks like blood.
And blood time, we got a bloody nose for Canetano here from Solon.
Yep, we're just cleaning the mat off and we're getting ready to go. 40 seconds left in the second period. Score is still 3-2. Shup.
Canetano takes, he's still down here. He looks for a switch and he's out. Quick escape there for Canetano. And now it's 3-3. 30 seconds left in the second here. Canetano's looking for that 2-on-1. He's got it. Let's see what he does with it, though. Now it looks like Shup's got an underhook. He's trying for a throw.
Oh, he gets that low single.
Let's see if he can dump it.
He's dumping him.
He's got 10 seconds to score here. Let's see if Canetano can fight it. He's got that leg hooked.
Oh, he's fighting that wizard in. Oh,
it's
no
a good
takedown.
Scramble there from Canetano. Good shot, but Shup's got a finish there.
Jake, hey, stay out of that bundle.
So Canetano takes down. Shup cuts him right away. Now it's 4-3. Canetano's in the lead here.
Go to the rush. Go to the rush. Go.
Let's see if Canetano goes back to that rushing. Shup's got an inside tie. He's banged. He's got an underhook, but Canetano's got head position here.
They're watching. They're watching Green, though. He's blocking down on that shoulder. He needs to get his head up. Oh! Half shot there.
Yeah, he doesn't have his head position there.
But
then now he's right into
the
single leg.
He's got a finish.
Canetano's got his wizard.
Trying to high leg that leg over. Canetano's got a strong wizard. He's hoping to get a stalemate. Oh,
well,
we get
and
it
there
potentially
it
dangerous. Minute 15 left. Canetano's up by a point.
He's in on that chin there. Canetano goes to the rushing.
Shup's trying to work the head down, and they call
and
a stalemate.
Still, man, there's some more blood on Canetano's
face.
And we're starting blood time. Looks like they got Canetano patched up. There's 48 seconds left
in this third period.
And then he goes, Canetano's right in on
right
shot. Let's see if he can finish.
He's
trying to swim. There's two takedown.
There's two, Canetano up 6-3. 36 seconds left in this period in the match.
Shops up.
Connor Thomas trying to turn. Got that bar in tight. Is he counting back? He's counting one. No, he didn't
just
give
a
it
one
to
count.
Whoa,
no,
whoa,
two
whoa.
Counts. They call potentially dangerous on the shoulders there. Shup still down.
Shup comes straight up. He's trying to turn in. He's going to try to throw him. Canetano's staying in there tight. He's staying down on that leg. 5 seconds looks like he's going to be. And they call it a set.
Unnecessary roughness on Shup. There's points Canetano. Canetano's fifth place.
Here we go.
Kraft and Doozy. Kraft was beat by Matt Kazmir in the quarterfinals. Doozy was beat by Brendan Fenton in the quarterfinals.
Both wrestlers are filling each other out. And gets a shot.
And this Kraft, he's in deep on a double leg. Let's see if he can finish.
Oh, he's scrambling. It gives him
two. There's two, Kraft.
Better belly down. Kraft straightens him out with a cross face. Got the leg locked in tight. He's going to try to.
Doozy sits in. He's got 5 seconds. Let's see if he can hook it here and score.
No, he didn't hook it.
It's a good scramble there by Kraft to hold on.
He didn't come through with he had to get all the way around. He didn't make it.
No change. Doozy defers.
Kraft takes neutral to start the second period and scores 2-0 Kraft. Both boys are keeping a low stance. They're head-to-head right now, trying to control their hips. Kraft shoots
in
again
on a single leg.
He's trying to get the dump, and he gets thrown out of bounds. No
good scramble there by
Doozy. Both kids are neutral. Start this. Minute 40 to go. Kraft takes a knee. He's trying to get lower angles, trying to lower his level. Oh, Doozy's in
Doozy's
on his
in. Hip. Let's see if he can finish here. Kraft's got his hips back. He's
Doozy's
got another hook there.
Lock, but now,
and now, reshot from Kraft. Snap down from Kraft there. And both wrestlers reset here. Minute 10 left in the second.
Oh,
Kraft's looking for a double leg again.
Doozy's looking to throw. He's got an underhook and an overhook. He's trying to get his hips in to throw.
Kraft's pushing back, trying to get his hips back.
Oh, toes are out of
bounds. Good effort from Doozy
nice
there. He had one leg in, another leg out of bounds. He's setting up that over-under.
Yes, that was a good toss, so he should have threw it a little sooner when they were a little closer to the center of the mat. 45 seconds to go. Both wrestlers looking for inside control. Kraft gets a leg.
Kraft's got a single leg here. Let's see if he can pick it up. And Doozy goes
trying
for
to
a
go
scramble.
Behind. Kraft's trying to get there.
There's two
for
Kraft.
Two. He throws the boots in. He's trying for a little power half there. Cranking on the shoulder. Ball's potentially dangerous.
There's a penalty point. 1 point for Doozy. Full Nelson there.
Oh, Doozy's going
to
try to
elevate here and try to. He's trying to get his hips high. He's running him over. Kraft's hanging on to the leg here in a scramble.
Oh, and here is a scramble. There's one change of control. 4 seconds to go. Scores 4-2. Kraft. They're both neutral. 4 seconds left in the second period. Doozy takes down and starts the third period. Doozy's down by 2 points. He needs to get up and out, take it down. Close match here. Ryan is 4-3.
Kraft's in again on a double leg. He's in deep.
Doozy's trying to scramble. He's trying to hold on.
He's got his arms. He's got a cross lift there, but Kraft's got to work up here. Let's see if he can hook and see if he can swim.
Still no change of control, and he sells him out. I think that's what Doozy was waiting on, trying to hold that center there. He wasn't trying to really take him down. He's just trying to hope for stalemate. Both wrestlers on their feet, moving side to side, trying to get that angle, trying to get that level. Kraft shoots in kind of far out.
Doozy's got a front headlock situation here. Let's see what he does with it. Kraft's holding the arm. And Doozy's in with a reshot there.
Kraft's banging the head, trying to get him off balance. Stretches him out, but he's got to come off his knees. You can't take him down on your knees there, boys. Gets a shot, half shot. Doozy corrects it. He's got a head and arm.
He's got the head, and it looks like he's trying to throw a mixer here. Our trip. He goes for an inside trip right
to
his back.
Yes, he throws a cement mixer. Should be getting some back, Sue.
Now he keeps that bar. That was nice. He throws that mixer, but he throws that trip there in a little wrinkle in his cement mixer. And now he keeps it barred up.
So there's 7 seconds to go, and he's leading by one.
There's two takedown, and finally he gets his two back points there. So now it's 7-4 to Doozy.
Wow, he's trying to put him forward, trying to get some more back points. Wow. He's burning time there. He's winning by 3 points. I'd stay there all day at the rest of the leg.
Cranking in, and he looks pretty.
Looks like a stalemate situation.
Doozy's pretty comfortable there.
Potentially dangerous, right. I'd sit there. He wasted about 15 seconds right on the edge.
And put a little torque on him, too.
Seventh place match, division 13 seconds to go. Doozy grabs down
on ankle. Yep, drops right down to an ankle.
See how long the rest go, let him hold that ankle. Well, it's potentially dangerous. Ladder stalling.
Looked like potentially dangerous there. 4 seconds here. And there it is.
7-4.
Spencer Doozy, your fifth place winner here from Willoughby South. The Elders in the white with the green anklet.
They're banging heads again, trying to get leverage.
Murphy's a sophomore here out of Elder. He lost to Lambert in the first round in an ultimate tiebreaker escape, 6-5. So it should be a close match again. Lambert from Brunswick, he's a senior.
Wrestling on mat number 2, belt 122. Division 1, 126 pounds for fifth place. From Cincinnati Elder, Austin Murphy. From Brunswick, Eric Lambert. On mat 2.
Murphy tries to dump it off there. He's got that single leg, but Lambert's trying to scramble through.
No control yet. Lambert's trying to hold on to get a stalemate.
And potentially dangerous on his knee there.
Murphy's
gonna take down.
Murphy is down. Score 0-0. Second period is 2 minutes. And we're started.
Murphy tries to sit out here.
Lambert checks.
Lambert does a good job holding the ankle there to follow. Now he's going to try to cut across and see if he can take him to his back here. Murphy's got to be careful.
Got to hold on too long.
He's in that cross lift. This is probably going to stalemate out here.
One, two, three.
Lambert elevates there, and there he gets his two near fall.
Boy, I think Murphy held on too long. He should have bellied down. He gave an easy 2 points, Ryan. And he was the one that wanted to take down. He thought he was going to get out. And he gives up two on a cheap tilt there. Lambert's in control. See if he's going to ride that bar out.
He's looking to dig that arm out, the right arm.
Coming out to the side. Got his chin back.
Murphy tries to sit. He's got a decent base here, Murphy, but let's see if he can stand up.
Murphy's trying to stand up. Lambert throws into the out of bounds, but they're both scrambling. No change of control. 46 seconds, and Lambert's riding him out this period. Plus, he got a cheap tilt. He's winning 2-0. 46 seconds left in the second period.
Lambert. Good breakdown here from Lambert. Let's see if he can dig that bar out. Right arm, he's looking for it.
Got the leg trapped. Lace. Lambert's trying to
still looking to bar up the right arm.
Lambert's now trying to slide the leg in with the right leg, but no. Trying to Granby. Murphy trying to Granby. He's got that inside leg. See if he can get it, but they're scrambling.
Now he's trying to scramble and sit out the back door here.
He's got to come off his feet there.
He's got to turn in, Murphy. He can't get his arm out. Lambert's got his legs over the body.
Looks like he's just going to hold for a stalemate.
It's a good scramble from Lambert there to hold on and not give up any points. So now to start the third period. Lambert takes down. He's up 2-0.
Up. Murphy cuts him right away. We start the period 3-0, both neutral. Lambert goes in half shot and almost got thrown, but base is out and he's in good position. He's got the arm locked for a dump. He's trying to circle in. The guy's hitting him in the face.
And they call legal crossface there on Murphy, so that's a point to Lambert.
So that gives us a 4-0 lead now. He's got a comfortable lead. Shoots in a half shot. Murphy checks him. He's got the overhook.
Murphy tries to snap.
Trying to snap down, and looks like Lambert's trying a little dump there.
Yeah, Lambert's got a good tight hold on that elbow there, and he's not going to let it go. He's pretty comfortable in that position.
Both up again on neutral position, trying to get the takedown. Murphy shoots in good on a high crotch.
Let's see if he can finish here. Lambert does a good job scrambling.
Lambert's got the leg. No points. Lambert's got to try to lock his lace, his left leg, but no, he's on
his head. He's got a head
snap
on here.
Oh, he gives up the two. Smart move. Belly down right away, not to give up back points. But now Murphy checks him out.
Murphy cuts him. So now it's still 5-2 to Lambert from Brunswick here. 50 seconds left.
Murphy needs another takedown. Hopefully, back points off that takedown. Lambert knows he's in control, so he's trying to lace down the arms, hold the arms in inside control, and just act like he's moving. He's blocking with the head.
Yep, and he's pushing forward, though, so he's got an aggressive stall, but now they finally called him for blocking.
Called him blocking with the elbows pinching in and the head blocking down. But that's his first warning. He has 20 seconds left to get called. He's got plenty of time to give up another penalty point. Murphy needs desperately to get in on that leg. Murphy's losing, so he has to shoot. Lambert's up. He really doesn't have to shoot. He checks him. He gets a two.
Counter shots there from Lambert.
Lambert's grinding the head on. trying to get back from when the boy socked him in the nose.
Great job!
And there's Lambert, fifth place winner there.
7-2.
Wrestling next.
All right, moving right along. Wild weight class, we've got Jared Rezovic from Aurora. He's going to be in the green with the red anklet. And then we've got Sam Dover, St. Ed's. He's going to be in the yellow.
With the green anklet. Both wrestlers come out with a collar tie, trying to move the head a little bit. High crotch from Aurora. St. Ed's trying to scramble. Dover's trying to scramble.
Rezovic from Aurora, he's a junior. Dover from St. Ed's is a freshman.
Oh, they stalemated.
Rezovic's in and they stalemated out. That's a good shot, though.
Rezovic was in deep, but just couldn't finish. The St. Ed's boy felt real confident there in that position. He wasn't panicked.
Dover's in on an underhook here. Rezovic's clamping down. He's got head position. There, nice high crotch to the right side.
Trying to lock the arm. No chance.
And into the period. And Aurora wins the toss and takes down.
Start the second period. He's down. Aurora's down. The score is 0-0. St. Ed, Sam Dover takes the top position. And he checks him down. Near arm breakdown. Bars it up. Trying to get his boots in there. He's trying to slide the legs in, Ryan. Trying to lace that ankle.
He's got that ankle hooked, but Resnick's trying to sit out here. Dover's trying to throw the legs over. Rezovic's doing a good job keeping the legs. Well, now they call it potentially dangerous there. Dover hooked that left knee with his leg. We're right back to referee's position here. Still no score. 29 seconds into the second period.
Dover's got to watch his back.
There's two reversal. No back there. Rezovic's trying to run this power half here.
One minute left in the second period. St. Ed's is down 2-0. Rezovic trying to work hard on this bar. He's got it laced through the crotch. They call warning on the bottom man for sitting there. He's kind of getting overpowered.
He's trying to run,
right now,
run up to the head and stack it up there, but and Dover gets his arm out. 30 seconds left here. There's a powerful chop there. Let's see if he can till him up.
No, and we go out of bounds. 30 seconds to go.
It's good top action right now from Rezovic.
Dover's coming in to take the down position. Rezovic's getting ready to mount. 30 seconds left. Rezovic checks him.
He's got that far wrist. Now he gives it up, but now he's working a tight waist here. He's got good forward pressure here, and he's keeping Dover's head on the mat. Now he's got a leg in.
Putting pressure on the head, he's acting like he's trying to turn him.
And really, he's probably going to hold on here and ride the period out.
Putting some pressure on Dover.
Making uncomfortable for him down there. 2-0. Jared Rezovic, Aurora. Dover from St. Ed's takes neutral. Start the third.
Rezovic is winning 2-0. So it looks like we're going to takedowns. Whoever gets these takedowns, Ryan. get a little physical there as they go out of bounds. Ref's talking to him right now to keep the physicality to legal. Make it legal, keep it legal. Good choice of reffing there. He took the time to keep it under composure. Dover gets in. Nope, he loses it. Rezovic changing every counter to what Dover's given at him. It looks like Dover's taking over control now of the movement.
This is a good snap there, but on the edge of the mat, we go back to the middle. Let's see. Right now, Rezovic hasn't been hit for stalling yet.
He's leading 2-0. St. Edgeboy has to
get a there he goes for a slide by. He's in on a single leg. Let's see if he can finish here. He's trying to run, but Resnick's got good hips there.
Keeps head.
He's got head pressure. Let's see if he can run him over or if he tries to stalemate it out. Dover's got to cut the corner here and come up. And there's the stalemate. That's what Aurora was looking for.
54 seconds. Sam Dover was in deep on that single. He just couldn't cut the corner. And we're back with 53 seconds to go. Dover's looking to get the takedown to tie this up and go into overtime. He's banging the head trying to figure out how he can get Rezovic off his balance.
He's doing a good job. He's got the inside tie here, but there.
Oh, he's got a body lock. He's lifting him. He's going to take him. Oh, no back points. But wow, Rezovic's still scrambling. Oh, count the back points. Now we got a tie, 2-2.
So we got a takedown Dover. No back there, no back.
Dover's riding him out.
He's got his legs in.
Rezovic's trying to shake him, and it's going to call potentially dangerous. 12 seconds to go. Red got penalized there. He grabbed the headgear. So we got now 3-2.
So now Dover has 12 seconds to hang on here, and he's going to win. He's getting high here, but he's got 5 seconds to see if he can hold on. And there it is. There's Dover, fifth place.
Wow, that was a great match. And of course, kid said he was pulling the headgear.
We had unsportsmanlike conduct somewhere there. So district kids here for fifth place, 138, James Weimer, Central Crossing, Jake Marsh, Marysville. Weimer was the winner of the Darby district. Marsh came in second, so Weimer beat him last week in the finals. Should be a good match.
They're still looking over the score there because we had some penalty point at the end from that previous match, so that's what's holding us up, folks. Now we're ready to wrestle.
Wrestling on mat number 8, 128.
And here we go. Weimer from Central Crossing. He's got the green anklet and the blue and white.
And the blue and black.
Jake Marsh in the blue and black with the red anklet.
Weimer tried his shot. He's trying to dump. Marshall's controlling the head. Now Weimer pops the head out. Weimer's trying to get it back in on that high crotch. He has a good high crotch. We saw in previous matches here in the state tournament. Marsh is blocking good. He bangs the head. Tried to get him off balance, but he didn't go for the leg. Weimer's controlling the head. Looks like they're going to burn out and end up 0-0 here at the end of this first period, Ryan.
Yep, no score here.
And we're waiting for the flip. And it's red.
Goes to Marsh.
Marsh takes down. Weimer will be on top. Start the second period. We have 0-0.
from Akron, Manchester, senior Joey Bowen. From Ashland, Mapleton, senior Joey.
Marsh comes up. He's got hand control. He's going to turn in, and his escape one. They're both up to neutral.
Weimer's in on single leg. Marsh trying to wizard here. He's got great flexibility, but Weimer cuts across. Still no chairs. Two for Weimer. He's up 2-1 now.
Trying to ride that bar. Got the head in there, trying to put pressure on the shoulder. Keeping that arm back. It looks like he wants to try to lace it on the back now, Ryan. Oh, he goes under it, but he doesn't get any back points. He's got to keep running it. Marsh escapes. He's back in on a low single. Weimer's trying to fight it off right at the edge. Marsh is bringing him back to the center. He's going to try to back trip. He's going to try to turn in. Weimer turns in. No takedown. It's still 2-2
here.
Weimer has to be careful there at the edge because last time he went out of bounds and turned in on the previous match, they called him for fleeing the mat. And it happens to be the same referee that's refereeing now.
From Poland Seminary, senior Dave
Escar. Marsh pushes action here. When we go out of bounds, we go back to the middle. Marsh is in deep here.
Step up. Well, Marsh is in deep.
Weimer's trying to wizard down here.
Lip arm.
And they call potentially dangerous on the knee there.
15 seconds, score still 2-2. Looks like they're going to burn this period and you're going to go into the third period. 2-2, Ryan.
Yep, Weimer from Central Cross is going to take down here.
Looks like Marsh is going to try to ride him. If he can't turn, they're going to kick him. We're going to end up back to takedowns again, Ryan. And the person who gets that takedown is going to end up winning this match. Marsh trying to ride him, trying to turn him. He gets a cradle in. But
Weimer's got high hips.
Arms aren't locked, so Weimer's going to be smart.
He squares up here, and we're neutral. 1 point escape here to Weimer.
Marsh has inside control though.
He's got head position and an underhook. And Weimer clears out. Marsh shoots.
Drag out.
Marsh tried a little dump there, but he didn't really have hard control on that tricep or elbow. Weimer's got
headlock. Somebody get down there and look at it. How do you see people?
We've got 1:10 left here. 3-2 Weimer.
Marsh banging the head. Weimer's just using his motion. Now they're both trying to change levels. Weimer picks it up a little bit. Marsh gets a shot, but he's way far out. Weimer's checking him there.
Marsh's got good head position again here. Weimer's got those double unders, but he's still backing his hips out there. They finally ding him for it. Marsh is in deep. It's a good angle pick from Weimer. He's caught him. Let's see if he can finish here. There's two takedowns.
You gave it to the wrong guy. He gives it to the wrong guy. Put the wrong hand up. He put the wrong hand up. Green is always in the right hand, folks. Referee got nervous here. Weimer's got a 5-2 control of the match. Referee put the wrong hand up. He gets one.
There. Weimer is the winner there.
Weimer wins.
5-3. Good match.
Vince Sutello,
As you see the tears of joy and sadness right there. Weimer's happy. Marsh is sad. Is it? The agony of defeat does come upon these young men.
Marsh is only
himself. Yes, sir.
Right along to 145 now. We've got Riley Regan, Miamisburg, and Farouk Muhammad, Shaker Heights. Muhammad's in the white singlet, red anklet. Regan in the black with the green anklet.
Farouk Muhammad is a freshman. We watched him last night.
Real good match against Demas.
But I think that took a little of his energy out. He lost the next match. But
yep.
There we go.
He got taken down. Reagan Miamisburg, he's the senior.
Tries to claw, gets a leg lace.
Please. 5 seconds here.
Oh, he's trying to get out. No, he holds it, and that's the time.
There's Red. Red's going to take down.
Muhammad takes down. Start the second period. He's only down 2-0, Ryan. He gets out, gets a takedown. He's right back in the ballgame.
From Miamisburg senior Riley Regan. From Shaker Heights freshman
Farouk
Muhammad.
Muhammad gets out.
That's a good quick escape there from Muhammad.
It's 2-1 now. Regan is up. Muhammad's trying to work the bars. Got good head pressure, but he's got to get his arm free.
It's like Regan's looking to control the wrists here.
Yeah, Regan's trying to control the ties. Oh, wow, Farouk.
Let's see if he can lift.
Oh, almost had a body lock there, Ryan. Regan fights it off. Wow.
And there, Muhammad hooks
Muhammad's
that leg. Let's see if
there.
He can finish.
They're fighting right at the edge. The squares
Regan's
off.
Got that 2-on-1, though.
Muhammad breaks out of that 2-on-1. He's trying to get his wrist free. Gets a shot, but it's blocked. Regan's blocking with his head. He's got an underhook. See if he can get this tie up. Both wrestlers are really concentrating on those arm locks and bars. Not much shooting going on in this match, but.
No, and we've seen that last night in the semifinals.
Oh, there's a high crotch.
Let's see if he can dump it off.
Regan's got long arms. He's got that lace through the center, blocking.
Blocking through the cross there. Now he's
in
right in the cradle. Let's see if he can
finish. See if he can turn.
He's got the leg hook in there, too.
Regan with 3 seconds left in that period gets the takedown.
So now he's up 4-1.
And it's Regan's chance.
He's
going to
take down here.
We're going to have Muhammad taking the mount position. And they're off. Muhammad's trying to lace that claw across the body. Regan's trying to get up his feet.
He's got a leg in here.
Now Muhammad gets his leg in.
Now he's working cross body.
Muhammad has him flattened out here, but he's got to try to turn, and they call it stalemate. Reagan's trying to come up.
Yep, Muhammad's got that wrist, though.
Reagan's trying to block and come up slowly. Doesn't want to give any back exposure. But he's winning. He really doesn't have to get out as much.
Yeah, Muhammad needs either a five count or two tilts here. He's got a minute's gone by. He's still losing 4-1.
And they're probably looking at the bottom guy because he's really not trying to get out.
It's true, but he hasn't been warned for stalling yet.
Just don't get cradled. Don't get cradled. You better have hand control. You better come up with hand control. Muhammad's trying to hook and push him over.
Breen's in pretty good position here right now. And they finally ding the bottom, man.
Coaches are desperately yelling for Muhammad to cut him. Finally cuts him with 20 seconds to go.
He needs a five-pointer.
He needs a throw here, Ryan. See if he can get it. He gets a shot at the high crotch.
Regan's playing the edge and backing his hips out, but he can because he's up 4 points here.
He's still backing. Looks like the senior overrules the freshman today.
Yep, Regan Miamisburg is your fifth place winner there, 5-1.
Farouk Muhammad now at the 152-pound class.
In the red singlet, we've got Andrew Sams from Fairfield. In the black, we've got Jacoby Ward. Moeller.
Cincinnati Arch Moeller.
Wrestling in that number two. Division I, 152 pounds, now 158. For fifth place from Fairfield, junior Andrew Sams.
Ward's a senior here for Moeller. Sams a junior.
Sams in on that leg. Trying to straighten it out, trying to straighten it out. He's got to get the takedown. He still hasn't got the takedown, but he's out of control. He's going to try to dump him now, back trip. He's got plenty of time. If he stays in the center, he's got plenty of time.
See if he can trip it. He's got 2 feet in, two on the edge of the mat. There's Sams from Fairfield.
Oh, they call potentially dangerous. He threw an elbow back to the face.
So there's a penalty point for Sam, so now he's up 3-0.
Your attention, please. Coach Gil Donahue from Massillon, Washington, has been penalized 1 team point for unsportsmanlike conduct. And the deduction will be assessed from team score.
Okay, now we got 3-0 because of the penalty point. They thought it was excessive elbow strike. He wasn't really trying to turn in.
It's on the edge of the mat there. We didn't really see it from our vantage point. But and Ward's out with an escape. So now it's 3-1 here.
From Sandusky Perkins, senior, 7-5.
Holding on there at the last 4 or 5 seconds.
Wrestling on mat number 3, about 150.
Green takes down. Red deferred of choice. Ward takes down.
From Mason, junior, Jack Stein. Mat 3.
And Ward's up and out again. Quick escape. He goes right for that
score.
Ward looking for that collar tie.
Ward's trying to get that. Oh, he shoots in with that control of the wrist. Now he's got that low single and he's going to finish. Toes in.
Sams has a whizzer here.
See if he can finish.
He's losing it.
He has a technical violation.
So they call Fleen.
Fleen for Fleen.
No takedown, but the penalty point. 3-3 here.
Yes, they give him the fleeing the mat call. Pretty close to giving the two, too. I would suspect that was almost a two.
Yeah.
So we're back to action here with a minute to go. No one's got the takedown, but Ward's in deep on
Sam's
him again.
Sam's whiffed on an inside trip there, and now Ward's in on a single leg. Sam's got the wizard in, but Ward's trying to pick it up here. He's on the
Ward
edge of the mat
on the
again.
Net,
there's
they give
two.
Him two. It's 5-3 now, and Ward's going to be on the top position. Sam's takes a down position. 47 seconds to go. Ward's coming up to the mount. And
we
got a caution on red, started too early. Trying to elevate
for
cheap tilt. There's a cheap tilt.
He's got the leg elevated. Is that a two count? Referees are conferring. And there it is. There's two back for Ward. So now it's 7-3.
Ward's going to try it again. He's got that cheap tilt in.
He's got a tight waist and he's elevating his bottom. He's got good hip position here.
He needed to lift a little bit more with his legs, but
now he's throwing in his left leg. Sims has 10 seconds. He's trying to hip over here.
He's just going to hold on, looks like. No change of control. 1 second. 1 second left in this period. I don't know if he can switch in 1 second. Well, Red didn't even try anything, so he knew he couldn't do it. Sam's takes neutral to start the third period. We got 7-3. Ward's winning.
Sam's looking for that. Looking for the head there. He's really starting to work the head here, Sam. His right hand.
There,
he reaches into a nice reach shot there. Sets it up with the opposite side high crotch and then right into his single leg. Let's see if he can pick this up.
He's got the leg.
Ward's
got
the wizard.
Pull in the center. Got to clear that wizard.
Ward's on his butt here.
Oh, trying for cradle. Two, they give him two because his weight was on his hands. Support points.
That's two there for Andrew Sams out of Fairfield. He's going to cut him here. So now it's 8-5. Minute 10 left. So an inadvertent whistle there.
Both wrestlers trying to work that arm control. Sams tries for a leg knee pick there.
Ward's pretty comfortable here.
Trying to put head pressure on Sam. He's staying on his knees. He's got to come off his knees there. He's trying to get the ankle.
For a far pick.
Trying to drag. Trying to drag him. I don't know if he can get it, though.
Yeah, but if it means that he's wasting time right now.
He's winning by 3 points. I really don't need to get that takedown right there, Ryan.
Nope. 26 seconds here. Ward's up 8-5. So there, Sams goes right off the whistle. He's trying to use that underhook, but Ward's blocking off with his head. That's stalling. He's backing his head there, they call it.
For pinching the elbow and blocking with his head, they call warning. 10 seconds to go.
He's still backing out. But there's short time here. Ward's just got to spin, and he's going to win this match. Be fifth place here.
Jacob E. Ward, Cincinnati Arch Moeller, fifth place winner, 152-pound class, Division I. Next, 160-pound, start of the 160-pound weight class.
Carpenter from St. Edge is a junior. Price from Elyria is a senior. Carpenter was second last week at the Perrysburg District, where Price was third.
Single man number 9, 165, Division 3, 152 pounds, for seventh place from New Lebanon Dixie, senior Luke Buxton, from Mechanicsburg, junior Corey Logan.
Both wrestlers trying to fill each other out. We got blood all over
blood.
The face of
Price. Blood time.
Price. Actually, there's blood on St. Ed's too. They need to clean him.
Wrestling on that number three.
No, it's okay.
And we're back here. 20 seconds left in the first. Still no score.
St. Ed's got an underhook. Trying to get the takedown. Banging. He's banging. It looks like they're going to burn this first period. Going into the second period on the flip of the coin. We have 0-0 going into the second period, and we're waiting for the flip.
And it's Red's choice.
Red's choice
takes
Lear.
Down.
Lear takes down. St. Ed's will be on top.
There, Leary is out. Price, good escape there. Didn't burn too much time on the bottom.
No, he didn't. Now he's trying to get that takedown. St. Ed's is in first place. Leary is in second place. I'm sure St. Ed's would love to win this match. They love to win all matches.
Price is in on a single. Let's see if he can finish. Let's see if he can finish. He goes for a trip. And there's two takedown.
He does get that takedown. He's just riding around the neck. Looks like he's choking him. Blood time now. Now we got St. Ed's. We were up there and these things were right. Okay, we're back on the air. Sorry about that. Here we go. Leary is back on top.
That's good stand up though from Carpenter.
Carpenter's got to turn in. Oh, they go out of bounds.
And we'll go back to the middle here. Minute 12.
Price is still winning 3-0. But Carpenter, oh.
Tossing
he went on.
Red. Full red, start on Price.
Red had his foot too far forward. Carpenter resets. He comes up. Price trying to work the legs in on him, Ryan. Got the legs in. Now he's working up on the head. Trying to turn him.
From Perrysburg, senior Robert Jones, at one.
Oh, they call a stalemate. That's a good call there. They're both
just legs in, sitting on the hips.
And all he's doing is wearing out. He's trying to beat up Carpenter's shoulders and back, neck. He's up 3-0 still. 52 seconds left in the second period. Price trying to get that claw in. Carpenter keeps coming up to his feet. Just can't turn in, though.
No. Price is going to push him out of bounds again. I'm going to start fresh here. 40 seconds left in the second. Carpenter is still down.
Price takes the top position. And they're off. 40 seconds to go. Carpenter's trying to move, but Price is kind of overpowering him there on the top. Price has the legs, and he's trying to crank the shoulder. He needs to come out to throw that.
He's got that in tight. He's got a punch down here, but he's got his right leg cut. He needs to get his right.
There he hops his
now
right leg out. Now he's going to turn.
Over.
Now he's walking him tight.
Short time.
Tight.
That's deep.
That hurts. Get it. Oh, boy, that's in tight.
Look up.
Get it.
Looks like that right left shoulder is still off the mat and time, but there's going to be three near fall for Price.
Carpenter takes neutral.
Take
he's down 6-0. Blood cleaned up. We're ready to start the third period. Again,
so
we have.
Here we go. Carpenter's
6-0.
Down. Price leads 6-0.
From Norwalk, Junior Abdullah Sylvie. From the Grand Museum.
Carpenter's trying to get in on that leg.
Price
can't
in on a single leg, and then he cuts across. There's two. He's got that right leg turned. Let's see if he can elevate. And well, now he's got a right leg in. Let's see if he can go back to that power half. Call blood time again.
Finally, we got cleaned up. Here we go, Ryan. Minute 32 to go. Carpenter needs to get up.
Attention, please.
And maybe a hip toss or something. He needs some points. They cautioned. They said that was the other referee.
That's the second one.
I think the other referee caught it, and he mentioned to the ref. That's how they caught that.
He's going for that spiral again.
Carpenter's Price trying to get to his feet. Price has it in deep, though. Trying
he's
to throw the boots
throw
in.
Legs, but now he goes back to the claw. He's trying to throw the right leg in over top, and there he's got him broken down.
Minute to go, and Price is in a commanding 8-0 lead. Now he's going to try to inflict some pain on St. Ed's here.
See, you can run that power half again.
Oh, they stalemate. That's a good call with the legs in. It's not really turning him.
Nah, he's just putting pressure on the head.
Carpenter back down in position. Price is pushing forward again, trying to get the boots in.
Now he's throwing his right leg in the left wing. He's got a breakdown there. Good breakdown for Price. 38 seconds left.
174, Division 3, 160 pounds. For seventh place, on Cadiz Harrison Central, senior Anthony.
Stalling on bottom.
25
seconds left. Price got it barred up here, but short time. He's got to work here if he's going to get a pin.
I think Price is content with being fifth place. Micah Price from Elyria.
Base gets a major decision there.
8-0 over St. Ed's Carpenter. Price is our fifth place winner at the 160-pound weight class Division I.
Got I think Alex Jones, Wadsworth. He's going to take a forfeit
over Brandon Goldsmith,
Westerville North.
His knee just couldn't go. His knee wasn't ready to go. It was banged up in the previous match.
So here we go. 182 pounds.
Jacob Bria,
Fairfield. Tyler Stepick, Lakewood St. Edward. We had Stepick last night in the semifinal against Russell from St. Ignatius, a high-scoring match. But right away, Bria is in on an ankle here from Fairfield. See if he can split the middle. He's coming out the back door here. Let's see if he can cut it.
Hold on to the ankle so he doesn't give it up.
Yeah, but it looks like Bria is still... He's still improving his position here. Let's see if he can turn in.
No, he calls it stalemate. Stepick was holding that ankle for dear life, Ryan. 23 seconds to go. Oh, Bria shoots in again. Low single.
He's in.
Bria's trying to come around. They're scrambling, though. Both boys are scrambling.
They call potentially dangerous there.
Wow, Bria's got a good quick single there. Low single.
Yeah, both guys moving pretty well for 182 pounds. Looks like the first period's going to run out. No score here.
Green's choice of St. Ed's. He takes down right away. So Tyler Stepick will be in the down position. Jacob Bria is going to be in the top position. Start the second period.
Division 3, 182 pounder, Josh Bialski.
Stepik is up and out.
He's up and out. It's a real quick escape there for Stepik. And now he's pushing the action. So 1-0 here. Stepik. St. Ed's with the lead. Bria pushed the action though in the first. Let's see if he can get on another shot.
Oh, here Bria's trying to redrag him.
He's in his single leg. They give him two.
Give him two. He's trying to work up. He's trying to work up. He can't stay down on that ankle.
And there's one escape. So now it's 2-2.
Attention, please.
Bria tries to drag him by there.
Oh, Stepik shoots in.
At the same time. Bria shoots from too far out, and Stepik's got his hips back.
Stepik checked him real well there. Now he's got the head and arm. He's trying to work his head a little bit. Stepik tried to shuck him by. No, they were out of bounds.
We're still neutral. 2-2 here.
Minute Boy, left that in the was second. A quick shuck by. 1 minute to go in the second period. Stepik almost had that takedown at the edge, Ryan. Bria's thinking he better go back to that low single because I don't think he wants to tie it with Stepik. Stepik's real strong snap down.
Well, there he
goes.
Go. Bad shot. Stepik spins.
He takes a 4-2 lead. 35 seconds to go in the second period, and he cuts him.
And there's one escape for Bria.
They're both neutral. 31 seconds to go, second period. The score is 4-3.
There's
oh, Bria gets a low single again. Trying
Let's
to cut the, corner.
Cut the corner.
Stepik has a good whizzer in there.
Tries a limp arm. Gets out of the whizzer, but...
But he's got good head pressure, and they call a stalemate. Jacob Bria needs to learn how to finish here on him. He's been in several times on that low single. He's just Stepik's scrambler, very strong. It's just hard to finish on him.
In time, Bria's going to take down here, start the third. He still trails 3-4.
Oh, Stepik kicks him, and now we're going to tie 4-4. We're both neutral. Go third period, Ryan.
Bria with a nice. See if he can use this underhook. He's got head position, but he's reaching around the lat. He's looking for that far wrist. He's not really using the underhook.
He needs to get his hips in more if he's going to use that underhook. Well, we're tied 4-4. Oh, we get a low single on him.
Let's see if he can finish.
Oh, he got the finish. His hands.
They give him two.
He's going to come through.
No change. Still no change.
Stepik's trying to throw him over. Looks like Bria's going to be content with holding on to the ankles there. They're trying to get a stalemate. They should get a stalemate. Now they call potentially
dangerous.
Dangerous
on the knee there, but still take down. 2 points there for Bria, and he's up 6-4.
Stepik starts to position it down. Bria's going to be on top. 1:04 to go. Stepik has to escape and get a takedown to win this match. And Bria has to hold him down to win. Both guys.
Stepik's up right away again, and there's the escape. So we got a minute left, and he's down one.
Stepik needs a takedown. Bria needs to not give it up. They're both banging. Oh, Stepik's in deep. He's going to come through the back door. He's trying to come through the back door. Looks like Bria's holding on for dear life. It looks like Stepik's going to step through. All he's got to do is get that left leg out, but boy, Bria's holding on strong. Oh!
They call potentially dangerous there in the scramble.
That was a good scramble there. 31 seconds. Stepik's banging the pressure. Oh, Bria gets a low single.
A low single. So let's see if he can finish. Stevic's trying to flee the mat there.
Oh. That was a close call.
Fleeing or two there, but as it stands, no points. Still 6-5. Stevic's got to push the action here. He's got 10 seconds. They finally called Bria for backing his hips out. 9 seconds here.
9 seconds to go. Don't get another call here. Step forward, son. He gets that low single.
He's on a low single. Let's see.
Stevic's trying to lift through the crotch. He's trying to lock the legs. And it's expired. And great match. 6-5. Bria's going to be the 182-pound fifth-place winner. And Stepik with a banged-up job here.
Yep, another forfeit. So A.J. Jones from Thomas Worthington is going to be fifth place at 195.
Another boy from the Central District, which is
Ben Fry from Dublin Kaufman against Jack Meyer from Moeller.
Gets a shot in, Fry does, but he's checked with a double underhook. Nice. Oh, and he gets a fireman's reshot. Fry tried a little back trip there, but boy, they're both scrambling. No takedown yet. They're right close to the edge of the mat.
Myers right in on a single leg. Let's see if he can finish. He's trying to bring him back in the center here.
Ben Fry's trying to just keep his balance and keep upright.
Yep,
wow, that's pretty good athletic ability for 220-pounder. Had his leg way up in the air.
Yep.
Good balance.
So it's Fry's choice here. He's going to take down.
We have a 0-0 tie. Fry fought that off very well for a big boy. Not giving the two up. So let's see what happens now. He takes a down position.
Myers got a breakdown here. Let's see if he can do anything with it.
Fry's trying to get back to his base. Got his head on the mat. He needs to get his head up and start finding hand control. Myers starts to control him. He's got him stretched out. Oh, he's got the bar in tight, right? He's going to run it. He's trying to run it. He's got to watch, keep that elbow, keep that shoulder from breaking his shoulder out. Oh, he's spinning. Got the knuckles on the back. They're trying hard to turn, but Fry with that long legs and long upper body, he's fighting it off hard. Getting his head rammed through the mat. Oh, he jumps across, and then he's going to jump across. He didn't jump across fast enough. Meyer needed to jump across to throw that half, but he's taking a minute off the riding time. Of course, you don't get points in high school, but boy, he's tiring out Fry on the bottom. Fry's trying to come back to a base, but Fry is just laid out flat. Trying to bar it up.
Yep, a good ride here for Meyer. He's trying to reach for that wrist there.
Now he's got the bar.
Two on one. Let's see if he can
try a cheap tilt. He's got to lift with the legs. Tries it again. Got 20 seconds to try to tilt him. Boy, that was a hard period for Ben Fry.
Yep.
He took down and he
didn't get out
pretty hard all period. He probably took some energy out of him. Let's see what Meyer does now in the third period. Meyer takes down, start the third period. Ben Fry will be on top. Dublin Kaufman both have 0-0. It's a real close match.
That was a quick move from Meyer. He's trying to sit through. Fry's, see if I can hold
Fry's
him down.
Fry's trying to lock him down.
We're going to go out of bounds and back down in a minute.
Boy, Myers was up in about a second. Let's see if he can find that explosion again and get out.
Good
Ben's
got
to hold him down to get a check somewhere.
There
oh, he
goes.
Misses
he jumps
it. He's back
right
up again.
And he's finding hands and let's see if he can cut through. So they call.
They called Ben. No, they called Ben Fry for pushing off the mat. I would have just gave one
so
to Red.
So Meyer's still going to be down here. 1 point for the penalty point, though. So now Fry's got to cut him, and it's 2-0 now.
Now Fry's got to figure out how to get the takedown.
No, he's reaching for a shot there. He's too far out.
Fry's got to try to set something up, but he's tall and lanky, and the other boy's short and stocky. And when you're short and stocky like that, it's hard to get underneath him. Fry's got to lower his level to get this takedown.
Now he's driving in.
Oh, we got a double arm bar here.
Myers looks like he's
trying to get around on him, but Fry's so strong.
And they're out of bounds.
Doug is winning. Up, they're back to the start, 40 seconds to go. Fry's losing, he needs to get a shot.
Here.
Tries inside trip,
but no.
Calling stalling on the red. Myers winning, though. That's the first
off,
warning.
Though. Fry looks for a trip. And it's not
time.
There. Meyer wins 2-0. He's fifth place.
Over Ben Fry from Dublin Kaufman. 220 pound class. They go out of bounds. We have Todd Hastings against Eddie Sternad, fifth place match.
Oh, here. Here we go. Third place match. 220 pounds. We've got Todd Hastings
Eddie.
In the green.
And Eddie.
Amherst Steel and Eddie Sternad, Brecksville Broadview Heights. No
right.
score, first period.
Right, we had the wrong information. I went up to the table and I said it, but Ryan didn't hear my headset, so now we have the right wrestlers
so
here.
So here we go. This is actually the third place match here.
As we've been doing fifth place.
So Sternad from Brecksville takes down. Still no score. Yeah,
Stern head still down. Oh, they're trying to tail him. Stern will roll through.
No back there. Hastings is looking for that tilt again, but Sternhead rolls through.
Wrestling on mat number 5, 206.
Sternhead's back down. Minute 27 to go in the second period. No score yet. Both wrestlers 0-0. Hastings trying to push forward. As Stern had elongated, but he's not really trying to turn him.
Let's see, he's getting high there. Stern had stands up, but Hastings brings him back to the mat. He's looking for that tilt again, Hastings.
Hastings really not trying to get out.
They go out of bounds. We're back to the middle.
Excuse
here.
Me, no SM. Stern edge not really trying to get out. His coach is yelling at him to do more movement on the bottom. 42 seconds to go, and we still have no score, Ryan. Hastings mounts up, and they're going.
Sternhead gets to his feet, but Hastings is trying to cradle.
He
rolls through.
He's gonna get back points.
Sternhead almost caught him, but Hastings rolls through. Gets three near fall there. And there's three. 10 seconds left here. Hastings from Amherst is probably going to take a 3-0 lead here into the third period.
Wow. Sternhead was out. Next thing you know, they roll around and he gives up 3 points. Now he's on the top position and Hastings takes the bottom position to start the third period, Ryan. And Hastings has a 3-0 lead.
Sternhead gets a breakdown, though.
Wow, he's kicking around on the bottom. I don't know what he's trying to do, if he's hurt or what. They called. We got the blood time down. Hastings takes down. Oh, the ref, like I said, there's still blood coming. Oh, we got the blood cleaned up. Hastings takes down. Sternhead's back on top. Minute 37 seconds left in this match.
Yep, let's see if Sternhead can get a turn here. Looks like he's working. He's got to hop sides if he wants to run that half. He's got that right wrist. Now he tries for a tilt here.
Oh!
And that's a quick
two. No, that was a quick two. The coach is yelling for two, but he might have had a one count on that. Yeah, definitely a one count. AC's back down. Sternhead's going to go top.
Looks like Sternhead's going to.
Oh, we got a caution from that far ref. Saw him. Touching that backside, he can't come all the way around with that foot. Sternad's checking him on this, see if he can turn him though.
Yep, they're gonna let him. I mean, you're keep down, letting him ride.
You're down on the bottom. Just keep moving, don't get turned. Oh, there's a count.
I don't think he got five, but he at least got two there. So there's his 2 points. Near fall. Let's see if he can get one more turn here. He's trying to dig it out. He's trying to tilt it up again. He's got his hips in.
Oh, that was another one count.
They gave him a, they got a two count. So he's sitting on two here. Serna now has just got to ride out. He's got two in his hip pocket. So there's two. Serna's going to win this 4-3. He's going to be third place here, 220 weight class.
Wow, that was a great comeback. He got two-point turn.
All right, we've got Drew Fenton in the red anklet, black singlet from Westchester, Lakota West. Quentin Mincy from Walnut Hills in the yellow. This is 7th and 8th place now at 220. Fenton's a senior. Mincy's a junior.
Here we are for 7th place now. We have Drew Fenton from Westchester, Lakota, and Quentin Mincy, Cincinnati.
Yeah. Just kicked it. No score here, 10 seconds left in the first.
Wrestling on mat number 5, round 210, division 3, 220 pounds for 7th place. From Martins Ferry, sophomore Hunter Biden, from Magador, senior Colin Kelly.
Mincy's choice is going to take down. And they cut him right away. There's 1 point for Mincy. He looks at a front hand position. Let's see if he can score here.
Both wrestlers just working on a bar here, trying to fill each other out.
For 5th place, from Olmsted Falls, senior Patrick Simon. From Copley, senior Armand Schumo.
Wow. Tries to...
Wrestling on...
Quick high crotch, but he didn't get the leg. Oh, Quincy snaps him down. Fenton's trying to get clear there.
And he's pushing back though. Fenton.
Looks like Fenton's got blood on his nose. Mincy's trying to control that collar tie, but Fenton pushes away. Yep. Mincy tries a half shot. He's still moving, though.
Yep, he's pushing the action. Well,
he's trying to circle around. He's trying to get him down. There's 10 seconds. Oh.
And there's two. Mincy.
Mincy gets it. 3-0.
So Fenton takes down here to start the third. He trails 0-3.
45.
Tries an ankle check. You got to come off that ankle. He comes up. Starts to work a power habit. He's got to get out to that, but he's on the wrong side. There he jumps sides. Missy's trying to turn him. riding that ankle now. He goes back to the half.
See if he can work a turn here, but
next on that five, 219.
Finn's got to stand up here.
Oh, he rolls out of bounds. No change of control.
It's like he's got it, looking for a cradle here. Mincy is.
He's trying to roll back, but better watch it. Any big boys.
He's got it. He's got it locked up. Let's see. He's got to get his knee in his side
here.
He's
got to try to jump sides in the air. You get the hip to hip and then sit through.
And he lets off of it. But Fenton's got to work here. He's down by three, and there's 50 seconds left in the period. Minsky's trying to. He's doing a good job keeping pressure forward.
Thirty-two seconds left. Fenton's got to try to find a way to get out and maybe get a takedown. If I was Minsky, I'd just be changing sides, trying to, you know, check here and there, and not really trying to do too much. You can always give him one. Just don't give him two now.
There's the one. Finn needs to work here, get a takedown.
Ten seconds to go. See if Minsky can hold on. Finn's got to get a takedown.
He's in on
Finn
shot.
Shoots in. Oh, Minsky circles.
Minsky's behind.
And
Minsky, seventh
Quinn.
Place at 220 pounds.
Yeah.
So we have our first Central District wrestler at 132. We have Jaden Maddox from Central Crossing. He's in a all blue singlet going against Zachary Donathan from Mason in a black and green singlet. Sophomore against junior. Maddox
placed last year
as a freshman.
Whoa, he gets a snap, but he's not got it. He doesn't have any two. Maddox is holding on to the head. He's trying to turn back and square off.
Used his long arms to get that ankle, didn't he?
He's trying to hold.
Going against this opponent, he's got to have multiple moves in a row, or he's got to have setups. But right again, that low single.
Wow, he snatched that ankle.
5 seconds.
Wow, he's not going to get it. Look, he's coming back up to his base. No chance.
Wow, Maddox, that was
Maddox
good
was,
defense.
Was in trouble two or three times, but he seemed to do some funkadelic to stabilize the stalemate. He ran through that. Let's see what Jaden can do. Maddox has got to get back around. He's trying to roll the ankles.
He's got the ankles. He's just got to get his own legs under him.
And try to lift through the back door. Now he's got that stabilized. He's going to
turn towards
the head. He's going to try to turn towards the head, and he's going to get him.
Oh, he can pin him.
Oh! Wow, I thought he was going to get back points. That was a quick belly down from Jonathan.
18 seconds, 2-1.
Wow.
Maddox has come to life a little bit here.
Yeah, he's changed his level, got that takedown. Now he takes a 2-1 lead. See if he can ride him out for 18 seconds. Hopefully he can.
Yeah, he bounced on him. Came down on him pretty hard. You know, he bounced.
Wow, that's his second caution. One more, he's going to give an easy point away. He's going to have to get his head under composure here.
Gotta lift.
Half.
Got a scramble. Scrambles in, actually scrambles from in a time code. Wise, in the favor of.
Wow. No.
Yeah. A little bit. You saw him pump it a couple times.
So he kicks him.
Oh, he kicks him. He thought he might be wearing him out for almost 30 seconds. See if he.
He's going to be coming after that low. Yeah, wow. Again, same thing.
Same thing. That was real easy, but let's see if he can dump him on his back. Wow, Maddox is still scrambling. They haven't gained change of control yet. I mean, there's for neutral
no
position.
Control.
No control. See if Maddox can lift that ankle up. They're going to call potentially dangerous.
They should. That knee is really.
That knee is way out of range. Well, Maddox keeps moving and he's grabbing on to anything he can.
But right now, he's got, he's giving up too much.
Now he's better watch his back. He's on his hip. He's on his hip. He better get up.
He needs to give up the two. Just give it up now.
Now he
get your one. Now you get your one.
And you win. You got 35 seconds to get out. Now
that's a stall call right there. Stall.
Green is stalling.
And the one.
Wow. Now you got.
All right.
Yes. Unbelievable. Ryan. See who I had at the beginning? He knows what's up. First Central Ohio winner so far in Division I this evening.
Thank you.